Welcome to round one with our blue-black draft deck. And let's start off with a mulligan, because only one land is not going to be good enough. This is better. The classic Festergloom Welkin turn combo. Well, there are some downsides. Or non-combos that we discovered in our deck. Not even sure I'm gonna play the Welkin turn on turn two. It's gonna depend on what our opponent does. Maybe in hindsight we shouldn't have put both of them in the same deck. Sacred Armory, what is this? I think I'm just gonna go with the Child of Night. I mean, our opponent might play a good blocker for it on the next turn, maybe like an invasive species, and that would be unfortunate. But if our opponent doesn't have a blocker, then this threatens like a 4-point life swing rather than a 2-point life swing. And it's typically better to play something that doesn't die to Festergloom. Speaking of invasive species, over something that does die to Festergloom. So now I could attack with Child of Night and then use Festergloom to trade, but that just seems... that doesn't seem like a play you want to make. I want to get a 2-for-1, or at least... when I use Festergloom, I don't want a 2-for-1 myself. I would prefer to stay at card parity, if at all possible. Gotcha. And now I can even attack with both, and if he blocks, yes, we get value. Oh yeah. It's kind of a suspicious attack if I just randomly attack into the invasive species. But if he doesn't block, well, that's fine as well. I'm definitely gonna play the Festergloom here, because I don't have much else to do, and it will open up the way for me to cast my Welkin turn next. No blocks, oh come on. Man, now I don't get value out of Festergloom. I guess I could wait a turn. Yeah. Why not? I mean, the worst thing that can happen is that I don't draw a land on the next turn. And, I don't know, get to a situation where I would have preferred to Festergloom away his Welkin turn. But the upside of waiting with Festergloom is that, well, maybe he blocks with a 3-3 on the next turn, or something like that. And I get a 2-for-1 out of it after all. Yep. Welkin turn. It's gonna put me down. Ooh. To 19. Fine. Okay. So he pumps once and then passes. That is very suspicious. What does he have here? Peel familiarity, maybe? So this could be like either peel from reality or maybe turn to frog, but it's an uncommon, or titanic growth, or just stone cold bluff. To get me thinking about all kinds of cards that my opponent would not even have. But I remember seeing some Peel from Realities in the draft, so I'm just gonna put my opponent on Peel from Reality here. So, what does that mean? Well, if I attack with everything, then he's just gonna block, most likely. Maybe he was putting me on Necrobite, for example. And thinks, well, now I can block if he has the Necrobite, and I just bounce his guy. So if he does that, if he blocks Child of Night here, then I play Festergloom afterwards. He will bounce, well, any one of these guys. And my Witch is familiar. And, nah, that is not an exchange that I am very happy about. Alternatively, I can hold off on the Festergloom for another turn until he taps out. Doesn't have to peel from reality up. And I just attack with Typhoid Rats here, because I'm probably okay with just this trade. Yeah, that feels a bit better to me. Just Typhoid Rats. Kaboom! Take damage. Oh yeah. Like that, Rats? Here's some more Rats. Hehe. Think you're so smart with your peel from reality. Nah. Don't get a chance to use it. Or maybe he's bluffing it, actually, and is sitting behind his computer saying, haha, you're so smart, thinking you're playing around peel from reality while I had nothing at all. Either way, we'll see what's up. Fine, I guess if all he's doing is just pumping his Vulcan turn, I guess I have to start doing something at some point. Yeah. Yeah, I cannot just be attacking with Typhoid Rats and, well, that's it, because eventually I'll just lose the race to his Vulcan turn. I don't want to be playing my Vulcan turn before my Fester Gloom. So I guess we'll give him a chance to use his peel here. Nah, he still has to choose one of his guys to keep, and he takes a bunch of damage in the meantime, so I guess that's fine. Do we even attack with all? What if he doesn't block? If he doesn't block, I gain life with Child of Night, so I don't have to keep back a guy, and he's definitely blocking here. No problem. El Gloom. Does it even matter what I keep up? I don't think there's any tricks that I can bluff either way. Oh, the minus 5, minus 0. Yep, let's bluff that one. Wait, that's actually bad. If he has peel, then he might want to bounce a Typhoid Rats, and then I don't have like mana to replay it. Even if that seems strange, he's just gonna bounce the Witch's Familiar anyway. Nah, probably doesn't matter what mana I keep open. And assuming that he indeed has the Peel from Reality, well, he has a choice to make. Does he keep Invasive Species or Vulcan Turn? I have to imagine it's gotta be Vulcan Turn, because Invasive Species is just stopped by Typhoid Rats, whereas Vulcan Turn, especially in combination with the Sacred Armory, was looking to give him a way to win this game. Ah, it's a Ranger's Guile, actually. Okay. Huh? But the first time he attacked with Vulcan Turn, he kept 3 mana up. So if a Ranger's Guile was all he had, he could have pumped an additional time. That is strange. Well, so maybe he does have peel after all. Or he was just semi-bluffing the first time. Not sure what's up here. Siege Worm, no problem. We have some Typhoid Rats against that, even if it means we're taking a lot of damage, but, well, that's still okay. Question is, do we play Zofshade or Vulcan Turn here? With our hand, it seems fairly unlikely that we're going to be pumping the Zofshade anytime soon. So I am inclined to just make the Vulcan Turn, because evasion, that's relevant. The only problem with that is that if our opponent has a card like Into the Void, and then bounces both of our Typhoid Rats, he can attack not only with Siege Worm, but also with Invasive Species, and we don't have any good blocks for it. And at that point we are a little behind. Also, nah, just gonna make the flyer. When in doubt, when the board is looking to be gummed up, just make the flyer. And keeping back both Typhoid Reds to play around. Well, at least something like a Peel from Reality or Frostlings. No, my Welcome Turn. Or, oh no, my Typhoid Red or whatever he wants to kill, fine. Whatever. I mean, if that is his big play here, I should be able to win this one if the game goes long. Ooh, Quickling. Does that help me? Not really. I mean, if I block with Typhoid Reds, I don't want to be randomly returning that to my hand. I guess I could just make Quickling and bounce Typhoid Reds, replay it so I have a flyer in play. That might not be horrible, but I'm not sure that's worth giving up the, well, potential value that it could get out of Quickling in response to, for example, a Hunt Weak or something later on. Yeah, because it was close last turn whether or not to play the Zopshade or the Welkin turn. Might as well play the Zopshade here. We'll see what he does here. Runeclawbear, well, that's acceptable. I have a, well, his Sacred Armory will allow him to well, trade Runeclawbear for which is familiar, but that's fine. Roaring Primaduct, so now he's he can go off. He has the invasive species, bounce it with the Primaduct. Get back meteorite combo as well, combo that takes a lot of mana, but a combo nevertheless. Well, he doesn't have enough mana to do that immediately, right? No, he can only make 2, 4, 7. If he plays land, he has 8. Wait, that is enough. I cannot count. So if he has a land, he can make invasive species and replay meteorite, which is gonna be quite annoying to be frank, which indeed I am. How do I get around that? Well, either I make a Rotfeast or Maggot, gain some life, but don't really progress my board, or I make Quickling, bounce whatever he kills. But then he's just gonna kill the Quickling after that. I think I'm just gonna hope that he doesn't have a land here yet and make the Maggot. This also has the main advantage of when I draw, like it's for example a tree casting cost card on the next turn, I can play Quickling plus that thing. When in doubt, in situations like these, I typically just go for the mana efficient play. Let's take out this Welkin turn. For a life, oh yeah. And I don't have any good attacks. Like any non-Typhoid Red creature would be blocked by a Siege Worm, and Typhoid Reds just get blocked by the Runeclaw Bear. He doesn't actually bounce the invasive species, he bounces the Runeclaw Bear. Interesting. Maybe he doesn't see the combo. Well, that's fine with me. Wall of Frost doesn't really do anything yet. If I attack with Zofshade, it's gonna get blocked by Venom Sliver. So, well, that doesn't really get me anywhere. Any other creatures also not able to attack profitably. So I guess I'll go for the Quickling. That way I add a relevant card to the board that can attack him. Nope, and he's still not returning the invasive species. That's good for me. Well, that's about something. I guess I can return the Rot Feaster. Make it to gain an additional life, but let's just bounce a Typhoid Red. I don't really care about the life. Mana efficiency is probably, yes, I want to return a creature. Mana efficiency is probably going to be more important. And now Wall of Frost in here, which is not very good actually. But might as well put it in here. Even if like my Typhoid Reds would die and he attacks with Siege Worm, he can pump a Siege Worm with the Sacred Armory, so my Wall of Frost would die. But then at least it's locked down a turn. That might be relevant if we end up in kind of a damage phase. There might have actually been an argument for playing the Swamp from my hand in case I draw Jace's Ingenuity. But I might as well keep it in hand to bluff something later on. Also playing Swamp here in case I draw... Wait, what's this? Sure. And I was going to say play Swamps in case I draw a double land and then pump to Zofshade one more time, more quickly. I mean, this attack allows him to trade this over here, but I'm fine with that. Yeah, I'll keep these Typhoid Reds around. When he's not bouncing his invasive species to get back to Nietzsche, right? And these Typhoid Reds are definitely more valuable than Witch's Familiar at this point in the game. And I think I have Wall of Frost to lock down his Runeclaw Bear. I don't think he has enough mana for that. Need 10 mana to bomb it to a 7-2. Child of Night doesn't do anything at all. But now I can actually start attacking with the Zofshade. If he blocks with Siege Worm, sure, that's a good trade. If he, say, double blocks with Primadox and Invasive Species, that is also fine. If he blocks with Species and Runeclaw Bear and then pumps one of them, that's not the best. But at least it would take out the possibility of him bouncing Species with Primadox and, well, seeing how good that could be. So, yep, might as well attack with this Zofshade here. Yeah, this is a trade I'm okay with. I could even attack with Typhoid Reds as well. He might block with the Runeclaw Bear and then randomly bounce back Species and think, oh wait, that's actually good. Don't want to give my opponent too many ideas. Block with the Siege Worm. That's okay. Gather Courage. Sure. No problem. I mean, I guess the Gather Courage wasn't really doing much anyway, but it's not the, well, it's not a trade I'm happy to make, Zofshade for Gather Courage. If I had known that he had it in hand, then I wouldn't have attacked, actually. But on the other hand, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so he can only pump it 3 times. Actually, attacking into Wall of Frost doesn't seem to make any sense. But if I block it down here, then it's probably just going to bounce up with Primadox and maybe see the Meteorite combo. So I think I'd rather just block it with the Rot Feast or Maggot. And then in case he has a pump spell, might as well throw in the Wall of Frost as well. Because, well, let's say he has Titanic Growth, Then he can make it into 7, 8, 9 power. So he cannot kill both. Yeah, this is fine. And maybe he messes up the ordering. Nope. Well, this block is okay. Least now my Quickling and Typhoid Rats are safe from his meteorite. I guess I could even start attacking with a Typhoid Rats. Yes, what's he gonna do? Block with the Prima Dogs? That's fine. Block with Siege Worm, definitely okay. Block with Runeclaw Bear, then he has to return Siege Worm. Yeah, this actually looks fine to me. Still keeping one Typhoid Rats back so I can block a Siege Worm. Okay. I mean, this might be kind of a play that's only good in a short term, because if he draws, say, another Runeclaw Bear, then oh, he's gonna bounce. It's well, that's also acceptable. Then he can start bouncing that to the Prima Dogs and still have these two threats in play. But nah, this at least gets something off the board. Guess I could attack with the Typhoid Rats as well. If he blocks over here, then they trade. He attacks me, I block with the wall, and then he might be dead to the Child of Night. But that feels a little risky. This way I still have a blocker back. That could be a bit better. Yep. Well, I'm not drawing much either, but I'm expecting my opponent to just have some lands in hand. In which case, well, he's either dead to my Quickling on the next turn, or yeah, he cannot really start attacking because then he's dead on the backswing. If you're asking why didn't I crack the Evolving Wilds, there's a huge strategic reason for that. I forgot. So let's just do that now. See, we're learning. Well, he has two cards. I guess one of them has to be a good one. It is the Peel from Reality. Maybe he has been holding it from the beginning. Yeah, let's wait. If my opponent has a counterspell now, then that's gonna be a little annoying. But at least waiting plays around Hunt the Weak, which is more likely. Don't forget to play it, like I did with the Evolving Wilds. Yes, return a guy, I don't know, Wall of Frost or something, whatever. Ooh. So now I could just clear the way, kill this, attack with everything, and even if my opponent has something like a Turn to Frog, I still win. That play is worse against, I guess, something crazy like Aether Spouts. But even if he has Aether Spouts, I'm probably still winning. Yeah, let's just go for it. Kaboom. Away with you, Siege Worm. Could have also not played it and not shown my opponent this card, but it increased my chance of winning the game, so it's relevant. Okay. Well, if you're just gonna pump, you're dead. Same deal. Okay, got there. Sideboarding time. I don't think there's much that I would be interested in. Let's sort by mana cost. That's how I usually think about decks. I was lacking some win conditions in the previous game. Didn't draw all that many. But I'm pretty sure if I had drawn like a Soul of Ravnica or maybe Shadowcloak Vampire or Nymphs of the Isles, even Jace's Ingenuity somewhere in the game, it would have been much easier to win this. No, I don't see any reason to change anything. Deck's fine.